Luke loves being in the bath. He's cleaned so gently, which is great, because his skin is very sensitive, especially on his bottom. I would like a wipe which cleaned him as gently as a bath would. Now I'm using new Pampers wipes.
Only Pampers have the new soft care system. Because they have many more long, soft fibres, they clean much more easily and so more gently than before.
And now they clean him gently, just like a bath, don't they, you little tinker?
New Pampers wipes, a gentler way to clean.
It's bigger. It's stronger. A whole new animal. Kellogg's Frosties, now loaded with B vitamins. 50% of the B1, niacin, and B6 you need every day as part of a nutritious breakfast. Kellogg's Frosties bring out the tiger in you.
A tale of the good guy versus the very, very bad guys.
Boom, bada, boom, boom, boom.
Take home Disney's Hercules from April 27th.
Hey, Kipper. You get all the booty sleep you can, puppy. Got you back on CITB, Wednesdays, 10 to 4.
But now we're off to Nutwood, where that little white bear with the snazzy trousers is going absolutely cuckoo. Over a clock.
Don't say I've gone and done it again. Ah, well, never mind.
Ah! Oh! Ah! Monsieur Gagol, I have seen something really odd in your kitchen.
That'll be the wife's cooking. She's not very good.
Maybe I am still affected by the fall.
Yeah, you want to watch out for her ratatouille? It would taste better if she used real rats. Anyway, listen, thanks for my teddy, Jack.
Oh, no problem. I admit I thought it belonged to your lovely daughter.
I'm ready, Jack.
We have this wanted poster to put up. I am after these criminals. I think you have seen them, no?
Seen them? I was only chatting to them on the ferry the other day. Are they criminals, then?
I stopped them trying to burgle your chateau. I believe your British police want to interview them, too. There was a jewel robbery in a fairground.
You know, the Panorama Fairground down the road, Dad.
Yeah. Well, listen, if there's any help I can give you, you know, pick them out of an identity parade.
I cannot see what I'm doing. My pile's more interesting than your pile. It is not more interesting. They're both boring. All paperwork is boring. Now, just... You want to do this lot? No, hang on. Just... No, Sooty. No. This is my paperwork. No, give it back to me, please. Would you let go? But I'm going to have to give you an easier job. You obviously can't cope with this. I'll tell you what you could do. Something easier, yes? Why don't you take all of this waste paper and get rid of it? It's just rubbish, all right? So I don't care what you do with it, just get rid of it. Understand? Right, take it away. Go on. And now perhaps I can get on with some work. Now, where's my pen? £40.80. That's £20.60. 14. Wait, just a minute. Just a minute. Come back here. Come here. Climb up. Listen, Sooty, when I said get rid of the waste paper, I didn't mean fly the Atlantic with it. I just wanted you to get rid of it. Just screw it up and throw it away. OK? Got that? Good. Right, off you go. Maybe now I can get on with my paperwork. £40.30. Excuse me. Stop. Come here. Climb up here. Listen, it seems obvious to me that you can't deal with paper in sheet form, so we're going to have to use... We'll use the shredder, OK? What? How does it work? I showed you how it worked last week. Oh, never mind. I'll show you again. The shredder. Now, it's a little bit noisy, but it's well worth it. Switch it on, you get a piece of paper and put it into the top like this. OK, there we are. And three goes, it's completely unreadable, completely unusable. There we are, fully shredded. Let's do it again. See, that's how you do it. It's quite good fun, this session, isn't it? You put a piece of paper in the top and down it goes, completely minced up. Got that? Right, you can do that and I'll get on with my... Oh, no! My paperwork! It's taking me ages to... Sellotape. Help me, don't just stand there. Oh, no.
What, Sweep? What's that noise? Well, unless my ears deceive me, Sweep, it's someone knocking on a door. Go and have a look. Well, what a surprise, Sweep. It's a lady. Shall we go and let her in? What time is it, Sweep? 8:55? Oh, well, in that case, let her wait. The public are all the same, think they own you. Think that if they call the shots, you'll jump through the hoop. Well, she can jolly well wait there until we're good and ready to open the shop. I don't care how much she knocks or how loud. Hello? Hello? Pardon? Pardon? What do you mean, pardon? Open the door. No. No. Why not? Too early? Too early? What do you mean, too early? Go away? Go away? Why? Oh.
God. All that work down the shredder. And I tell you something else, that's not the only thing that's in shreds either. My nerves are in shreds, and do you know the reason why? Sooty and Sweep and Sue and little cousin Scampy, their attitude towards the customers that come into the shop is absolutely appalling. Anyway, I've decided to do something about it. A touch of staff training. You know Connie? Connie Crichton, that's the lady that's on the stage shows with me. Well, she's been on this course, you see, to learn all about this staff training. And she's going to come along this morning to give us a few tips. Actually, she should have been here by now. Cough. It's come to something, hasn't it, when the person doing your staff training arrives late. What, you actually showed the woman this sweep? Go away? But why?
I'll tell you why, Matthew.
Why?
Because the shop was still shut. She had no right to be banging on the door like that.
But you mustn't speak to people like that.
Well...
You don't speak to people like that. Well, you don't speak. Look, I'm very worried about your attitude towards the public, which is why I've got somebody coming here today to do a spot of staff training. Has she got blonde hair? Well, yes, she has, actually, Sweet. She's not coming. How do you know she's not coming? You showed her the go-away sign. Well, there she... Sweep, that was Connie!
Connie?
Yes, Connie Crichton. It wasn't her you told to go away, was it? You didn't recognise her? Oh, for goodness sake, you lot. You've just got no manners. That's your problem. What do you have to say for yourselves? Come on, what do you have to say? Really? Matthew is a wobble bottom. See? No manners.
Oh, that's just not true, Matthew. You're only joking.
Well, I'm not joking, Sue. You have got no manners. I mean, look, for example, see this toast rack? Who took the last piece of toast in the toast rack? Sooty took it. Well, there you are, you see. No manners. If you've got any manners at all, Sooty, you would have offered that piece of toast around before you took it. Did someone else want it?
Well, I didn't.
And neither did you. Yes, but that isn't the point. You see, I may have wanted it. I can have it. No. I don't actually want it, Sooty. I'm welcome. No. I don't really want it. It's mine. Listen, Sooty, that is not the point.
Well, it looks as if you've got it now.
Look at that. Just a minute. That'll be Connie. That, don't forget best manners, OK? And first impression stick. Coming. Oh, Connie, it is you. Oh, how can I ever apologise enough? Sorry.
No need. Scampi let me in. Hey, and he's given me a bag of delicious-looking sweeties by way of apology.
Scampi? Yeah,
and if you'll excuse me, I think I shall just try one.
No. If I were you, Connie, I really cannot recommend that you actually eat one of the sweeties.
A birdie!
Hang on a minute. She's eating one of Cousin Scampi's joke-peppered hot sweets. So just do something quickly. Connie, put your chin down quickly. Put it down. Open your mouth. That's better. That'll be much, much better. Connie, are you all right?
I think I'll live. We haven't got off to a very good start, have we?
No, I'm sorry. Look, shall we start all over again? Shall we?
Oh, I suppose so.
Okay. Hi, Connie. Yeah. Hi.
It's good. Oh, for goodness sake! We're stuck together!
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's the jam on the hand from earlier on. I'm sorry.
What was that you said about first impression sticking, Matthew?
Oh, look at that. Jam all over my hand.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yes, okay, I'll ask it. Hold your hand up, Connie. Hold your hand up. That's all right. You've done it now.
That's enough. Look, can we just get down to the business in hand, please?
Yes.
I think you'll find that strawberry jam is the business in your hand.
And that's enough for you, young lady. Look, I know you all think of me as just good old Auntie Connie.
Yes, we do.
But I've spent a long time looking out to this staff training business. Right, now, please, will you pay attention?
Yes.
Now, I'm going to walk up to this counter and pretend to be a customer.
Right, yes.
And I want to see how you act towards customers, right? Now, you can go one at a time. Sooty, you're first, right? And the rest of you, shoo.
Off you go. Right. Jolly good. Okay, ready, Sooty?
Service? Excuse me, young man.
Sooty, look, she's talking to you. She wants you to serve her.
That's
Why don't
better.
I do it? Well, look, I'm not here to serve her. She wants you to serve her. Put the comic away. Sorry, Connie.
Thank you. Right, now, I want you to come up with some suggestions for something that would be suitable for my little grandson.
What? You didn't know that she had a grandson?
Matthew, I haven't got a grandson.
I know,
Connie. I am just pretending. I am pretending to be a grumpy customer.
Yes, exactly. You're doing a very good job as well, Connie.
Well, thank you. Now then, this is absolutely ridiculous. I demand better service. Now, young man, I want you to come up with something suitable for my grandson. And when you do, I shall want a full demonstration of the product. Right? A full demonstration.
Don't just look at me. You heard what she said. She wants you to think of something for her grandson, and then she wants you to go and get it, and then she wants a full demonstration.
Correct.
A full demonstration. Go on. Apparently he's gone for something. Is he a boisterous little chap?
I should say so.
Oh, really? What could be right up his street?
Excellent.
Oh, no. It's the water pistol again. And now for the full demonstration. What? Give it to me. Look, I'm sorry, Connie, but you did ask for a full demonstration. I don't know how to apologise. Really, I don't.
Well, you could start by getting me a towel.
A towel? Yes, a towel. There's one down here. There you are, Connie, a towel.
Listen.
Do you want to just, call this whole thing off? We could do that. Call it off.
Certainly not. No? I've spent a lot of time on this staff training course, and I'll train this lot if it kills me. And it probably will, too. Mm. Right, where's the next assistant?
Go and get Sue. Go down there. Sue, could you come? Oh, there she is.
Oh, right. Yes. What is it?
Now, Sue, I'm going to pretend to be a customer and I want you to serve me.
Well, you can wonk till you're blue in the face.
What?
I'm not serving you.
Not serving me? Well, why on earth not?
Because it's staff tea break time. Come on, Matthew. This position is now closed.
Oh, no.
Position closed? I suppose that means you're all going off for a cup of tea and you're going to leave me here.
Look, I'm sorry, Connie. I'll see what I can do. Sooty, would you come up here? Sorry, it's coming. Come up here. Listen, it's staff tea break time and Connie doesn't have anything to drink. Do you think you could just get something for her? Just anything? What sort of thing? Well, I don't know. I mean, just something that's warm and wet, I suppose. I mean, that would do, wouldn't it, Connie? Anything, really.
I mean, I don't mind if it isn't warm, as long as it's wet.
You can fix that. Well, apparently he can fix that. No! Connie!
Why did I have to open my big mouth? Can we just all relax? You've had your tea,
yes. And
I'm more or less dried off.
Good.
So can we get down to some staff training?
But of course.
Come on, where's the other assistant?
Well, she's gone to get a bath towel in case you have another little accident.
I don't think that's going to be necessary, Matthew.
Why?
Since I have got the dreaded water pistol now.
All right.
Now, I've put you on that side of the counter,
yes.
And I'm going to stand here,
mm-hmm.
And I'm going to show you how you should behave towards customers. You see, this is how we did it on the course, Matthew.
Oh, I see.
Right, and you are now about to witness a demonstration of perfect customer relations.
Got you.
Ah, and right on cue, hey, a customer. Good afternoon, madam.
What?
Good afternoon, madam.
You're talking to me?
Hey, yes, madam.
Well, the name's Mole from Market, not Madden.
Oh, Mo. Oh, of course, Mo. Anything you say, Mo. You see, the customer's always right.
Oh, is that so?
Of course, madam.
Oh, good. Well, in that case, you can split this fiver up for me. Now then, I want £3.50s for the meter outside, £1.10s for the phone, and give us £1 for... arcade.
I'm sorry, I'm afraid that's not possible. Because, you see, it is company policy not to give customers change. If you want change, there's a bank up the high street.
Now, listen, Matthew and Sooty always give me change. Why can't you?
Because, my good woman, I choose not to.
Listen to me, banana brain. I am not your good woman.
Banana brain? You can't call me banana brain. I'm not a banana brain.
Yes, you are. And yes, I can, because you see, like you said, the customer is always right. Now then, I'm a customer and I'm in your shop and I am asking you to give me something. So give me what I am asking for.
Right, now. As your staff trainer, I want you to take particular notice of this.
Yes.
A customer has just entered the shop.
She has.
Apart from the fact that she was at the end of the queue when brains were given out, she has asked for something, and it is my duty to give it to her. So, madam, I have great pleasure in giving you exactly what you have asked for.
You were right, Sue. We did need the big bath towel after all. Especially when Mo started to fight back. Yes, I've never seen so much water. But it ended up all right. Yes, Connie and Mo ended up the best of friends when they saw the funny side of it.
Well, she did have a point, didn't she, Matthew?
Oh, yes, Sue. I mean, you should always try to be polite to people. And you know, Connie's little saying is one that we should all try and remember. The customer's always right.
Patience, you need patience. Think of the people who come in the shop and can't make their mind up. They dither about till they think it's a wind-up. Think of the business and don't lose your temper. Try to remember the customer's always right. Don't get yourself in a fight. You can tear out your hair, but the fact is still there. The customer's always right.
And that is extremely good advice.
Patience. You need patience.
Think of the people who pick up a vase, then ask for another. Different shape and different colour. It would be easy to get in a temper. Always remember,
the customer's always right. Don't get yourself in a fight. You can tear out your hair, but the fact is still there. The customer's always right.
Do you know I am worn out?
Patience. It's not easy to keep your cool. Gracious, but we deal with some fools.
Patience. Sit down quietly on a stool. Calm down,
customer's always right. Don't get yourself in a fight. You can tear out your hair, but the fact is still there. The customer's always right.
Now don't forget the simple rule, okay?
The customer's always right. Don't get yourself in a fight. You can tear off your hair, but the fact is still there. The customer's always right.
Well, we hope that you've all enjoyed this trip to Sooty & Co. If you have, join us again soon. But until we see you again, we've got a message for you. All together now.
Bye, everybody.
See you again soon. Bye-bye, everybody. Come on, Scampi, wave. Oh, you are waving. Come on, Sweet, wave to everybody. Bye-bye. See you again soon. Bye-bye.
When you join us at 3:45 tomorrow, Ozzy the Owl will be learning all about spooky things that go bump in the night. Bring your nerves of steel. That's tomorrow at 3:45 here on CITV. Coming up next, Mike and Angelo are set to scorch your TV set with Angelo's hottest idea yet. Looks like a bit of a burnout to me.
Oh, we've really done it this time.
Once upon a time, a young potato called Edward awoke from a dream of a far-off land where all potatoes are kings. Deciding that he must search for this land, he packed up his favourite presenters, cartoons, music and stars. Waving goodbye to his brothers Chip and Sauté, he hit the road, feeling ready for anything along the way. MASHED, starting the 2nd of May on CITV. Life's full of surprises.